Welcome to the third and final part of our audio tutorial. This time around, we'll add music to our map. On our example map, we'll set three different types of music. Global, playing automatically on the whole map. Ambient, for building atmosphere after going into the tunnel. And finally, an action piece, playing when we're fighting a goon. Let's start by defining the global music track. On top of the objects list, we'll select our level. We go to the attributes window and select the fields tab. We set the music in n_music_preset field. Let's open the list of available presets and select one of them. For example, default_02. Default presets are specifically prepared to play globally on open area maps. They consist of a lot of short music themes played randomly with intervals. The music we set will be played across the whole level, but we often want it to change depending on the situation or location. In those cases, we use the music area object. The sound played by this object is attributed to the music group, which is different than in the ambient zone, which has its own group. Because of that, you can control the sound's volume specifically from the game's menu. Let's use the music area object to set ambient music in the tunnel. In the assets window, let's find the music area object and place it on the map. The new box can easily get confused with earlier ambient zone boxes, so let's hide them for the time being. In objects, we can select ambient zone, right-click it and select Hide Same Class. Let's get back to the music area. Music will be played only within the specified area and will override the global settings. Let's move it to the tunnel and scale it to encompass its geometry. Now we can set what kind of music we want to play in this area. Let's open the attributes and open the list in m_music_preset. Let's select one of the pieces of ambient music, for example, ambience_03. We can check if we like the preset by selecting the flag in the playfield. Now we have ambience music ready, but we want dynamic music to play when fighting a goon, which will fade after killing the enemy. The easiest way is to place another music area in the space the combat will be happening. In the case of overlapping music areas, there will always be one track playing. The last one the player entered will override any previous overlapping areas. Let's put in and rescale another music area and name it. Like before, we'll select a fitting preset. For example, attack_goon_01. Let's go see how it works now in the game. Okay, so the music plays correctly, but the dynamic action doesn't stop after the goon dies. Let's correct this. We'll connect a spawner to the music area. Thanks to this, the music area will only be active when the connected spawner, or spawners, are active. Let's go to our music area, music_goon_fight. In the attributes window, we right-click on the m_spawn boxes, and we select Insert References to Objects. Let's remember the spawner and music area can only be joined if they are within the same group. We add the goon spawner to the music area. Now let's check if this time the music will stop after the death of the enemy. Okay, so now everything works as intended. And that's it for our sound tutorials. Thanks so much for tuning in.